Hello all my creative people and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today's episode, basically I'll be discussing 5 quick questions that you should expect when you're attending or you've been called for a photography interview, and I will be sharing with you guys tips on basically what you need to know and how you need to prepare for your interview. Guys, basically going for an interview, any type of interview, is actually nerve-wracking, and obviously you might find yourself trembling at times. So what you need to do is basically prepare yourself for common interview questions that you know that are more likely to come up. Those are questions like, obviously, did you study for that certain course? What interested you to study for photography, and when did your passion for photography begin? Questions that will forever come up on interviews, so you need to be prepared for that. And guys, you also need to learn about the company. You need to do thorough research about the company. What sort of company is it? What sort of establishment is it? Obviously your role, or whatever, what they are calling you, for a photography position, but you need to know about the rest of the company, like who's going to be managing you, if you're going to be managed. You're going to need to do your research, your background research about the company interview. You must always make sure that you arrive 30 minutes prior to the interview, because number one, you don't want to arrive late, or arrive at the time that the interview is supposed to start, or 5 minutes before, and you do not want to arrive an hour before, because you're just going to be sitting there and you're going to be getting more nervous and you're going to be working yourself up more. So you just need to arrive maybe 30 minutes before, so that you're going to be prepared and ready for the interview. From the minute you walk into the establishment, you must make sure that you treat everyone with respect. Do not be rude, because you must greet, you must be humble, you must be respectful, because you never know who's going to be interviewing you, because the person that you might see when you're entering the door and you don't greet and you're rude about it is the same person that you might actually get to see sitting in the panel, who's going to be judging you when the time of your interview does come. You must always stay on topic, guys. Please remember that. Do not divert. Just try and keep your answers simple, as short as possible, because the minute you start rambling and the minute you start going on and on, that's when you're actually going to get confused and you're going to divert from the topic or the question that was being asked of you. So just make sure that by all means you do try to stay on topic, and yeah, try to remain calm at all times and take deep breaths. Remember that you are qualified, and they wouldn't have called you for the interview if they knew that you were not qualified, or if they were not interested in you. So the mere fact that you were called amongst the few for an interview, knowing that thousands had applied, you must know that there's clearly something special about you, and you must just have confidence in that. And guys, please try by all means to avoid discussing money and benefits, especially if they were, however, stated on the advertisement of the job, unless if you have no choice. Maybe you were working at a certain company, and from that company you are earning a certain amount, and here you are being interviewed by another company for that position, and you're not sure how much they're going to be offering you. Obviously you do need to know in that instance how much are you going to be leaving behind to come, obviously, to this new company. But otherwise, if it was stated, I mean, you already know, so there's no need for you to bring that up during an interview. And you must also have follow-up questions, because there will come a time in an interview, that time does always come, believe me, when they will ask you, do you have any questions? Don't be like, no, I don't have any questions, because that's going to seem so weird, guys. You must ask a question, ask something, even if it's just one question. Like, for example, you can ask, like to know about the company's work ethic, or what does the company expect of me? Besides all that they had listed on the advert, what are the company's expectations of me? Do not ask weird questions like, when are you going to get to go and leave your holidays, and are you going to be paid extra for overtime? Those are questions that you shouldn't be asking. Just ask questions that are going to work for you in regards to your interview. So guys, basically this is just a short video that is gonna help someone somewhere in regards to attending photography interviews. I have attended quite a number of photography interviews, and these are questions that are going to be coming up are questions that you know 100% that they will be asked. Assist you guys as a photographer if you're attending a photography interview. During your interview, you must make sure that you keep eye contact to whomever is asking you the question, because interviews might differ. They might vary in terms of the company or establishment rules. Some establishment or companies will have one person interviewing you, so that's like easy because it's just a conversation between you and that person. And some interviews might be different. You might have a panel of 3 to 5 people. So just make sure that when you're answering a question, you try and keep eye contact to the person who's asking you the question. Don't look down, don't look sideways, don't fidget, just remain calm and don't be rigid. You know, just remain calm, take deep breaths, and most of the time they'll give you a glass of water. So if you feel that you need to drink, it's always okay to drink, guys. Don't be scared to take a sip and just gather your thoughts and continue, because the most important thing is that you get the job. And just try by all means to avoid eating a burger during an interview. By burger, I mean, you know how when you're thinking about something and you will be like, that basically sounds like you chewing something, like you just had a bite of something and then now you're chewing it. Just try and avoid those moments during interviews. If you are thinking about something, you can say, thank you for your question. That's actually a very interesting question. While you're saying that, you're basically gathering your thoughts and your ideas on how to tackle or how to answer a specific question. Guys, before we begin, I would like to introduce my brother / cousin. He's the one who's going to be helping me with this interview. His name is Mbulelo. So introduce yourself.
Hi YouTubers, how are you?
Okay, so we're gonna get right on to the questions. We have 5 major questions, interview questions. He is gonna be playing the part of the interviewer. I'm gonna obviously be the interviewee. And these are the 5 basic important questions that you're gonna need to know if you're going for any photography interview. So let's start.
Okay, Yolanda. How did you develop an interest for photography?
Okay, basically, to be honest, when I grew up in a township, and there was this man who was living next door. He was a very creative person, a very creative individual, so he was also a photographer. Mm-hmm. At that point in time, I don't know whether he did study photography or is just a person who was mm-hmm. passionate in photography, mm-hmm. but I remember that I basically used to visit him, and he would show me different pictures or photographs that he took with his camera, and then he'd show me like which settings he used for the photographs. And then he, for me, that sparked an interest, and I was like, oh, this seems interesting. But back then, obviously, I wasn't sure if I wanted to be a photographer or not until I basically did my grade 11, and that's when I basically saw that I'm more into arts than anything else. And I'm a person who's an outdoorsy person. I like being like outdoor instead of just, you know, being indoors. So I'm not really an office person. Mm-hmm. So photography best suits me, because I do have those times where I'm actually in the office where I'm editing and whatnot. But then most of the time I'm actually traveling around, exploring different locations. And basically it's fun and it's beautiful. It's just seeing the world, you know, and in your eyes, and sharing that with the world. So
that's really amazing, Yolanda. That's really amazing. So next question, what equipment do you prefer to use?
Okay, when it comes to equipment, I'm comfortable with different types of equipment, because obviously I am a professional photographer, so I am able to use different types of equipment. But personally, I'd say that in my first year and duration of my tertiary studies, I did however use a Sony and a Nikon camera. But in my work career, I've mostly used the Canon camera. Like I can say 85% of the time I've been using the Canon camera, so I am comfortable with Canon.
Okay, that's really awesome. Third question, Do you collaborate well with second shooters or assistants?
I do actually collaborate well with different photographers, because I do understand that sometimes I'd get a project and the project would be a huge project, a project that I can't actually do on my own. So that's when the second shooters and different photographers would come in play, because obviously we would tackle that project together. And but then I do believe that if you're going to have second shooters, because people have different styles of photography, so you need to understand that. And if you're going to have different shooters, you need to understand that you must have preparatory meetings with those people, exactly. So that as much as they have different styles of photography, but at the end of the day, when you produce a project, the project must be a combined project. Even though a person might be able to tell that, okay, this is not Yolanda's work, this is not whose work, but at the end of the day, the work just must be of high quality. So I do work well with different types of photographers, but I do believe that obviously with planning, any project can be tackled. So,
wow. Okay, that brings us to our next question. Do you have any formal training?
I do have formal training. I did study at the University of Durban University of Technology, where I acquired my national diploma in photography. And I've had different workshops, photography workshops in GCIS, that's the government communications system. I've also basically did an internship with the KwaZulu-Natal Office of the Premier, and I've worked in different establishments being a photographer. So I can say yes, I do have formal training and training thereafter.
Okay, sounds awesome, Yolanda, really does. That brings us to our last question for this interview. What is your photography process?
Okay, my photography process is that I basically have a three-step process. That's my personal process. I have pre-production, I have production, and I have post-production. Pre-production comes into play where I'll basically do research regarding a certain project or an event that I'm going to be doing. I do a research in terms of weather. Is it going to be raining? Is it going to be sunny? So that I know which equipment that I need to carry. Where is the location, the nature of the event, like what other creative can I bring to that event? Are they going to need a photo booth if it's a wedding or some event? What will they need? So that's my pre-production, me just doing research basically. Transportation wise, how am I going to get there? Is it a project that I'm going to just do in one day, or do I need to be there for more than one day? So I need to do bookings in terms of accommodation, as well. So, and the surrounding area, obviously I need to do research in the surrounding area. Is it a safe area? What type of area is it? What people coexist in that type of area, so I can basically just try and blend in with the community when I do reach that place. And production, that's where basically I'm doing the day of the event. Basically that's me photographing, and with that as well, I also do have like I would take your intro shots for me. Basically that's the beginning of the event, when people are walking into the event.
Things and like then, red carpets.
Yes, and then I will, depending on the event, and then I will have those creative shots. Mm-hmm. I'll also have your cutaways. Your cutaways are basically those little details, your shapes, your texture, your color. I also like to incorporate that into my photography. And obviously I'll also have like sort of a conclusion. The conclusion is basically me summing up or rounding off basically the whole event as a whole. And in regards to that, I always make sure that I shoot. For example, I know that people are actually big on social media nowadays, so when I do shoot, I will however alert the person that I'm shooting for, my client or a person, anybody who's close to the client, and just let them know that I will be sending through via social media maybe 10 top best pictures for that event, so that like obviously I'm gonna need time to edit the rest of the pictures, but before but while you're still waiting for the pictures, at least you're gonna have 10 pictures of basically that are gonna remind you of the day. I'll shoot the first post, sit down, edit quickly. While I'm editing, My camera obviously has my memory card in there, just in case something happens and I do need to capture more, it's fine. My laptop will be here, my camera will be like on my shoulder, strapped on my shoulder, and I shoot, and then the first session, and then obviously I'll send it to you, maybe three best photographs, second session three best photographs, and then the last session I'll send you about four best photographs. So post-production, that's when I do most of my editing. That will usually happen the day after the event or at night, the night of the event, where I'll edit the best pictures that I have taken of the event, and then I'll compile a package. If it's maybe a wedding or that type of event, I'll compile a package, and then as soon as I can, I'll print the pictures. If the pictures need to be printed, I'll put them on a disc if that's the agreement, or I'll basically just send them to you via email as per our agreement, as customer and worker deal that we have. So basically that is my process of photography.
So yeah, Yolanda, all I'm hearing is perfection and perfection, and you're always prepared. So yeah, that's really proper.
Thank you for that. Preparation is best at all times. Thank you.
So thank you for having me, Yolanda. It's been an honor.
I'd also like to say a big thank you to those people who've actually reached out in social media. They know who they are, to actually tell me that this YouTube channel, they're excited about it because they're hoping to learn certain things about photography. I'm also excited about it as well. And to those people who've actually shared ideas with me in regards to my channel, in how I can add content in terms of what visuals they would be looking forward to seeing next. So I'm actually very, very thankful to those people. Please just keep on watching, guys, and keep on subscribing, and many, many thanks.